आरुषि रेज्ड योर हैंड।
मैम आई फॉरगॉट टू रेज इट डाउन, इट वाज
ओके ओके नो प्रॉब्लम। नाउ नीड हेयर फसिंग टू कंजर्व द रिसोर्सेस। यस, जस्ट इन प्रीवियस टू थ्री क्लासेस वी जस्ट हैव अ ग्लैंस अबाउट द प्रेजेंट सिचुएशन, प्रेजेंट कंडीशन ऑफ अवर नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस, एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंज्यूम्ड, दे आर एट द वर्ज ऑफ द फिनिशिंग। सो हेयर कम्स द अटमोस्ट नीड दैट वी हैव टू कंजर्व, वी हैव टू प्रिजर्व दीज रिसोर्सेज फॉर अवर फ्यूचर जनरेशन, and that we can do successfully by managing them in a sustainable manner, right? Second one is to prevent the damage which is caused due to over exploitation of the resources. We know that our population is increasing day by day, and so are our basic needs. And to fulfill all these basic needs of the people, that is of food, clothing, and shelter, etc., what we are doing, we are simply exploiting, we are simply over exploiting our natural resources. And this over exploitation, in a way, they are causing this, these methods are causing a lot of damage to our resources. Now, lot of damage resources means, for example, we are making use of agrochemicals, so they are simply leading to the deterioration of the soil fertility, right? That is one example. The another example is that we mine out metals from earth crust. In chemistry, there is a topic regarding your metallurgy, that is extraction of metals. So what do? We just obtain metal from earth crust in the form of its ore, then we separate, we extract this metal from the ore through various many different kind of chemical reactions, right? And during that particular process, one waste material is released, which we call it as slag, and that is a huge slag is released just in the mining of 1 ton of metal, and that slag is dumped as it is in the nearby water bodies, or it is just dumped onto the soil ground, right? So although we are exploiting resources, but we have to be more considerate that when we are exploiting our resources, we should also ensure that we are not damaging them. Means our actions are not going to pollute our environment. आपने जिस रिवर से आपने पानी लिया पीने के लिए, आपकी नीड सक्सेस हो गई, आपकी नीड फुलफिल हो गई, राइट? बट अगेन जस्ट आफ्टर फ्यू डेज यू आर डिफिकेटिंग इन द सेम रिवर, एंड नाउ यू आर मेकिंग दैट रिवर टू बी यूज्ड फॉर ड्रिंकिंग वाटर फॉर द रिमेनिंग पीपल। तो हमें हमारे एक्शंस को कंट्रोल करना है। वी हैव टू जस्ट पे अटेंशन टू अवर एक्शंस दैट इफ वी वॉन्ट टू एक्सप्लॉइट रिसोर्सेज, then we have to devise those strategies which will not pollute and cause damage to these resources. And this again can happen only if we follow eco-friendly and those methodologies which will lead to sustainable management, right? Another important part here is to ensure equitable distribution of resources, to ensure equal distribution of resources between every individual, that every individual has right over these natural resources, right? But in present situation, what is happening, that a pocket full of powerful individuals, because they have position and money, they are exploiting natural resources like anything. And on the another side, there are some class of people who are really dependent upon these natural resources directly for their survival, right? For example, if we take the situation of current industrialists, And on the other side, we can take the example of the tribal people. Now, for industrialists, if there is one forest insufficient for supplying the raw materials, they will look for any other source, right? But the tribals, they are found to live in the forest, in these natural resources, from long many centuries, and they cannot survive without these natural resources because these are very important for their survival. So, sustainable management will also help us to ensure that these resources are equally distributed, equally available for every class of the society for exploitation, right? So here are the three main reasons that why we need to manage our resources in a more sustainable managed way. So to conserve them for future generation, to reduce the damage which we are causing, and thirdly, to ensure that it is equally available for every individual, right? So that is about the need of sustainable management of the resources. And this concept of sustainable management of resources is not very new. कि अगर हम ऐसा सोचें कि अब एक just a few years back only the scientist, the environmentalist, they have proposed this concept. No. If you just have a look in our mythology, that is, I'm talking about nearby the time period of Vedic period. Vedic period means when our Vedas were being framed, जब हमारे वेद लिखे जा रहे थे, right? So in that Vedic period, if you have seen some television programs which are based upon mythology, like the Rama and other things also, then you might have realized that in Vedic period, a due importance were given to the sustainable management of the natural resources. For example, that is a philosopher they used to live, जो आपके ऋषि मुनि होते थे वो जंगलों में ही रहते थे, पहाड़ों पर रहते थे, right? वो वहीं पर छोटी सी झोपड़ी बनाकर उसमें अपनी लाइफ को स्पेंड करते थे. लेकिन कभी ऐसा नहीं, उनकी पॉपुलेशन धीरे धीरे इंक्रीज भी हुई, उनके बड़े ग्रुप्स हुए, लेकिन कभी उन्होंने जो नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज थी उनको डैमेज नहीं किया. इनफैक्ट इफ यू जस्ट गो थ्रू द स्ट्रेटजीज, द गाइडिंग प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ गुरुकुल एजुकेशनल, जो बिगिनिंग में लोग गुरुकुल में जाते थे एजुकेशन लेने के लिए, वहां पर एक प्राइमरी सब्जेक्ट होता था कि हम अपनी रिसोर्सेज को कैसे कंजर्व करेंगे. बिकॉज दे यूज टू tell them that these natural resources, they are also a form of life. उनको उस समय भी पता था कि अगर resources नहीं बचेंगी तो हम भी जिंदा नहीं रह पाएंगे. Like that, so it's not a brand new concept. In Vedic time also and prior to that also, a due importance was given that we need to conserve resources, take only that much which you need, because no thing can supply you the materials to satisfy your greed. Okay, तो हमें सिर्फ नेचर से उतना लेना है जितनी की हमें जरूरत है. Okay, so it's not a new concept. Now after that, now we will just have a look slowly one by one in two main important resources, and in that one, the first we are taking is that is forest and wildlife. Forest and wildlife. Now about forest, you all have learnt in your previous classes, right? So what comes to your mind if I ask you a question, what is a forest? Kya aata hai aapke mind mein agar aapse koi puche what is a forest? Yes. No cramped definition, just put it in your own words. Kya hai forest? You learnt in 7th standard. You learnt in 7th standard. Yes. Okay, so till now only one has raised. Okay, Shubh Lakshmi, tell.
Ma'am, a large area of land covered with trees.
Okay, large area of land which is covered with tree. Okay, Sanya, what would you like to add here? Sanya Sharma.
Ma'am, a large area which is covered with diversified trees and animals.
Okay, a large area which is covered with the diversified trees and animals also. Okay, what about others? Okay, what Kanishk would like to add here? Kanishk Sharma. Yes? Kanishk, are you there? Is Kanishk present here? Tell. Not responding? Don't know, ma'am. Okay. Okay, Harshita, what would I like to tell?
I'm a large area where we'll find it.
Okay, that's all your definitions are pertaining the point that how our forest used to appear. That when we talk about the word forest, we get an image in our mind that many trees are there, many kind of herbs, shrubs, climbers are there, and in that huge population of trees, we see animals found living, right? So that a picture of forest. But in present scenario, the forest are defined as these are biodiversity hot spots. These are biodiversity hot spots. Now, biodiversity means any particular region which is rich in flora and fauna. And when we talk about flora and fauna here, especially we are indicating towards their endemic species. I hope you know the meaning of endemic species, that these are those species of plants and animals which are exclusively found in a particular area or region, right? So forests are biodiversity hotspots because they are rich in life forms. They have got varied forms of plants and varied forms of animals, right? But this is the half definition. So biodiversity, they are rich in variety of plants and animals, but in present situation, their survival is threatened by human habitation. That is the complete meaning of the term biodiversity hot spots. Biodiversity hot spots. Right? So, although they are containing plants and animals, different variety of plants and animals, but at the same time, their existence is threatened due to the extensive human activities. In fact, it has been proposed by the biologist that we include those natural resources in our hot spots list, in which almost 70% of the vegetation is already exploited. Un forest areas ko hum hot spots ki list mein add karte hain jinka jo 70% vegetation hai wo already humne exploit kar liya hai, and at the same time it has not been regenerated. It means we have already used our 70% of the forests which were existing on the earth, right? So first thing to remember, the meaning of the term biodiversity hotspot, because it is a new term which is being introduced here. So aage se jab koi aapse puchega what is a forest, the definition should include these two words, that forests are the biodiversity hotspots. Biodiversity, there are those regions which are rich in variety of flora and fauna. And yes, those variety which are endemic to that particular region. But their existence is threatened by human activities. Means we need to conserve, right? And in past many years, we have practically seen that it's an immediate need to conserve the biodiversity, because biodiversity is totally required for maintaining ecological stability on the earth. अगर हम अपनी डाइवर्सिटी को कंजर्व नहीं करेंगे तो हमारा जो इकोलॉजिकल बैलेंस है वो टोटली डिस्टर्ब हो जाएगा. एंड यस दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन प्रीवियस ईयर्स, राइट? सो दैट इज फॉर फॉरेस्ट. नाउ वी नो दैट एवरी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन फॉरेस्ट, राइट? एवरी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन फॉरेस्ट. सो वेदर यू टेक other animals or you talk about we human beings, in 7th standard you learnt about those things which we get from forest, like spices, many medicines, timber, firewood, etc., right? But dependence of a particular individual upon these forest, it varies, it differ, and based upon that only we have categorized the stakeholders of forest. The particular group जो है human beings का, उसकी कितनी dependence है forest पे, based upon that criteria, that up to what extent a particular human being group, they are depending upon forest for their survival, or for their any particular purpose, we have divided them into categories. And we call them as stakeholders. Stakeholders means any particular person who is dependent or interested in a particular thing. So here, stakeholders of forest means those persons who are having interest in the forest for different objectives or different aims, or those persons who are depending upon the forest for their various needs. So let's see what are these categories of stakeholders of forest. So here the first one are tribals, or you can also just call them as the local people. Yes, tribals, or these are those local people which are found to live inside the forest or around a forest, right? And it's not very new. For many of the centuries, tribals and local people, they are living in the forest because their dependence, their survival is just because of the forest. We'll see just one by one in detail. Then second group we have that of the industrialists. Yes, those people who are owning a particular factory or industry means they are involved in manufacturing of various commodities which we use in our day-to-day life. For example, we are using paper, so that paper is being manufactured in paper mill, and that paper mill owner is getting the wood for paper from the forest only. So that second group is industrialist, right? Then the next group is our Forest Department of India. Forest Department of India, yes, these are those government personnel or agencies which were so called saying take care of our forest, means that how many people can take forest products, up to what level exploitation can be done in a particular forest. All these guidelines, rules, regulations, these are framed by Forest Department of India. So that is the third stakeholder, right? And the fourth one is, that is the nature enthusiasts, you can call, or that is what we say, that is nature lovers also we can call them as, or conservationists, means it's a group of social group people, that is they do just social work because they understand the need that we need to conserve our forest and wildlife, because our life is depending upon that. Okay, now let's see one by one each group in detail that how they are dependent on forest and do they have any role to play in conserving the forest, right? So first one we have, that is for these tribals, the local people. So as I already told you, local people means those people which are living inside the forest or around the forest. Now these people basically they are dependent upon forest for the fulfillment of their basic need. Now basic need means they take firewood, they take timber also, then they collect fruits, spices, nuts, they take medicines, then they also take wood, especially for, that is for making the slats of their hut and for making various implements which they use for agriculture and fishing. They also take thatch. Thatch means aap Hindi mein bolte na ghas phoos. So the basic English term for ghas is grass, and for phoos we call it as a thatch, which we use, which these people use for making the roof of their hut. Okay, so all these materials they take from forest only. It means if we drive out a tribal group out of the forest, then their survival will be threatened. And same work is being done by our forest government at many places just in the name of development. In fact, some powerful people, industrialists, they have taken in consideration the government together, and just they have also put an allegation over these tribal people that basically these are responsible for the over exploitation of the forest. But is it like that? What do you think? आपको क्या लगता है कि जो ट्राइबल पीपल हैं, जो सदियों से हमारी फॉरेस्ट में रहते आ रहे हैं, क्या वो हमारे फॉरेस्ट के ओवर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन या जो डैमेज उनको हो रहा है उसके लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल हैं? सो वन आंसर आई गॉट फ्रॉम आरुषि, नो. व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? कृतिका मेहरा, नो. ओके, हाउ विल यू जस्टिफाई योर आंसर? जस्टिफाई योर नो. आई ऑल्सो थिंक द सेम, दैट दे आर नॉट रिस्पॉन्सिबल एट ऑल, बट आई वॉन्ट सम सॉलिड पॉइंट इन सपोर्ट. कैसे? हाउ? Yes, you can speak up. Okay, Kritika Mehra, tell why you think it's a no from your side. Tell.
Ma'am, because they use that resources in a very limited manner.
Okay, so according to Kritika, tribals, they use resources in a very limited manner, and I also support her point. Okay, what about others? Quickly raise your hand, you're not participating in discussion. It's very general topic. Shobhan, speak up. Yes, you're writing better, you speak.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell.
When the tribals use their resources in limited way, and they mostly prefer reusing of the things that can be reused.
Okay.
So ma'am, tribals.
हाँ, who this is speaking?
मैम तनिष्क.
हाँ बोलो. राइट, टेल.
मैम ट्राइबल्स जनरली यूज फॉरेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स एंड देन दे यूज टू ग्रो अप द सेम प्रोडक्ट्स एंड दे डोंट हार्म एनीथिंग इन दिस प्रोसेस.
ओके, व्हाट तनिष्क वांट टू टेल इज दैट व्हाटएवर प्रोडक्ट्स, थिंग्स और प्लांट्स और वुड दे आर टेकिंग फ्रॉम द फॉरेस्ट, एट द सेम टाइम दे ऑल्सो एंश्योर दैट दीज नंबर ऑफ प्लांट्स आर रीजनरेटेड. मीन्स अगर उन्होंने कुछ प्लांट्स को कट किया है तो वो उतने ही प्लांट्स को ग्रो भी करते हैं. ओके, व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स पीपल? ओके, सुहानी, टेल.
यू रेज मैम ट्राइबल्स आर, मैम ट्राइबल्स आर फुली डिपेंडेंट ऑन फॉरेस्ट एंड दे कैन नॉट थ्रेटन देयर डिपेंडेंसी, सो दे कैन नॉट
Yes.
Deplete forests.
Yes, because tribals, they know one thing for sure. They know the ground rule that if forests are going to disappear or they are going to damaged, then we won't be able to survive. Tribals say jante hain ki hamari jo life hai forest ki wajah se possible hai. Agar humne forest ko khatam kar diya, tumhari life bhi khatam ho jayegi. Okay. What about others? Speak up. Very few people are just taking part in discussion. Adesh, kuch kahoge? Yes, speak up something. Adesh, are you there? Adesh, are you there in the class? Yes. So I want to give attendance to Adesh. Seems just he has turned on the class and not present. Okay, what about Ayush Batra? Ayush Batra. Yes? Yes, ma'am. Okay, you are there. Tell. Why do you think that tribals are not damaging the forest? No? Okay. So almost whosoever gave the point, your points are correct only. And as I can see, the time is almost up. Another teacher is just on the roll only, waiting for the room. So just let me one more time call out the names. And let me tell you, students, that you might be thinking in the end, madam, repeat the name. So those who are joining in the end, you will get the attendance. Actually, after every Google Meet class, we have attendance report generated from Google. And that shows the time duration for which you have attended the class. So there we come to know ki kuch bachon ne 2 minutes se attendance ke liye join kiya, to unko attendance nahi milta hai. So just be careful. We have got ways for everything. Dimple, Kashish, Riya. Okay, yes, Riya is present. Saloni Vaishnav, Devinder, Kartike Singh. What happened to Kartike Singh? Anyone?
Ma'am, Dimple is present.
Dimple is present. Kartike Singh, anyone? Kya hua hai usse? Or he is a willful defaulter? Shriya Rai? Parth Sharma is not there.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, Parth Sharma is present. Okay. Rohit Raj? Not present.
Shriya Rai present, ma'am. 10120.
Okay. Shriya Rai is present. Okay. Akanksha Tripathi? Akanksha Tripathi? Nandini Bhatt, Varsha, Abhishek Dagar, Arpit Singh, Ayush Kahar, Rahul Swami, Shubham Adiwal, Tanishk Yogi.
Ma'am, Tanishk Yogi present.
I marked you because I remember you interacted with me. Yes. Okay. Yes, Nandini, I have marked your attendance. Okay, yes, now you can leave the meeting. And thank you. We will just
continue
the discussion in the next
class. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, so meanwhile, you can collect a good number of points so that you can tell me next class. Okay, bye.